called tranquilizer. I thought this suggested a slightly relaxed version of the Spanish Inquisition. The name suspended from the neck of a ceramic stalk, killing time on one leg by the front door. There was quite a large garden, beautifully kept. The silver porch was parked in the drive. Sergeant Troy chose the bell rather than the knocker and got a brief, shrill earful of the dawn chorus. Dennis Rainbird appeared. "Well, hello again." He seemed delighted to see Bobby. "And you brought a friend." He gave Troy a radiant smile, which bounced off the sergeant's stony countenance like a ping-pong ball on the concrete slab. "Come in, come in." "Mother," he called over his shoulder, "it's the constabulary." "Oh, but I was expecting them." A gentle fluting from some distance away. "I'm in the lounge, Dave," Carol's voice. It managed to sound every vowel the word possessed, and generously tossed in another O for good measure. At the end, Mrs. Rainbow rose from her downy cushion as for a nest. She was very, very fat. She spread outwards and towered upwards. At least a quarter of her height seemed to be accounted for by her hair, which was a rigid pagoda-like structure, a landscape of peaks and waves, falls and curls, every sharp point, like an inverted ice cream cone. It was the colour of butterscotch instant whip. She wore a great deal of makeup in excitable colours, and a lilac caftan, rather short, revealing bolster legs and tiny feet. The chief inspector fielded her welcoming glance, direct and sharp as a lancet, and introduced himself. "I knew you were on the way. I saw a car drive by, and I was sending some swallows on the telephone wires. Such a charming arrangement, like notes of music. Oh, perhaps it was you I glimpsed the other morning when I was in Church Lane. In your loft, I think. An excellent vantage point. Hide is a term we ornithologists prefer, Mr. Barnaby." A nip in the air, Barnaby begged her pardon. She waved a sparkling hand. "Won't you sit down?" Barnaby sank to an armchair, thickly barnacled with lumps of crochet. "And what about you, dear?" Dennis danced around Sergeant Troy. "Don't you want to take the weight off those legs?" Bristling with machismo, Troy selected the hardest chair